Hello everybody and welcome back to Dune's Let's Plays. I'm Dune and welcome back to Mafia, the Definitive Edition. We just finished a trip to the country, and I don't know what we're moving on to now, but that was an absolutely disastrous omerta. Still 1933. But yes, last episode was disastrous. It did not go well, the little deal that we had going on with the Canadians. Morello's corrupt cops dealt with us.
Sit down, Tom.
And what's going on now? Oh, he's got a suit on now, which is banging.
We have a mole, Tom.
Oh, no.
No. Who?
I was up all night driving myself nuts trying to figure it out. I started thinking maybe it's one of our guys. We aren't paying his fair share. Someone with a light wallet.
Maybe looking to Morello for a new suit.
Frank wasn't around, so I went to the safe to get the account books. To see who's getting cents on the dollar he's earned.
Oh no, don't tell me it's Frank.
What do you know?
It's Frank.
The books are gone, Tom.
The books are gone.
Frank.
No, Frank.
More than 50 years I've known him. Everything I have, I got with Frank. And every buck we've earned, every dime we've paid out, it's all logged in those books.
Oh, crap.
Frank hands those over to the feds, we're finished.
Frank respects one person in this whole town, and that's you. This has got to be some kind of misunderstanding.
I've been calling him all day. I went by his place. He's gone. His wife and kid are gone.
Mm-mm.
But why?
Oh, no.
I don't know. I'm sure he has his reasons. Maybe he's still smarting over the dog.
The one you tried to drown.
Yeah. Same one I shot after he wouldn't let me sink her.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I was a stupid kid, Tommy. Grudge or no grudge, we gotta get those books back.
Oh yeah, we do. We're finished. We're all done.
See who knows what.
I've got this,
you
Tommy.
Catch up to Frank. You get those books, and if he doesn't have them on him, you make him tell you where to find them. After that, you do what we gotta do.
Kill him. Yeah, we can do that. Oh, there's a couple making out over there. In the background.
Vincenzo's waiting for you with a clean car.
Oh, sweet. It's my boy, Vinny. Hey, Vinny, how's it going? That is a very nice looking car. Hi, Vinny.
Day to day, Tom. We gotta keep a lid on this, Tom. Start with Biff, but don't give him nothing. I got you a clean set of wheels. And something special here, if you want it.
What's the special thing? Oh.
When Frank sees a La Para, he'll know. The old ways work.
Nice. Love a nice wee sawed-off shotgun. Detect dime detective. Death gives a permanent wave. I am loving that car, though. That is looking nice. Drop. We're going to skip the journey again. Okay, so we only got a shotgun right now. That's fine. Let's get moving on. We need to catch up with Frank as soon as we can, so let's get moving. Hi, Biff. We haven't seen you for a while. How you doing?
Tommy, what's the rumpus?
Heard any big news lately? Something that Don might want to know.
It depends. What's it worth to you?
$20.
How about 40?
All right, spill.
The FBI's in town. They're getting something from Morello, but I don't know what.
Our account books.
Little Tony got some guy drunk in the Black Cat and drove him home. Heard a bunch of stuff, so he's the guy you want to see.
Okay. Thanks.
Always a pleasure, Tommy.
Thanks, Beth. Find little Tony. Right, let's go. So the FBI's in town. Well, that can only mean one thing. Morello's wanting Salieri out the flipping picture. See, better parking than what I could ever do, right there. I've been here before.
Everything okay, Tom?
Wait, is this the bar from the... Is this the bar from the... This is the bar that we're in... No. With the detective.
It's not. What's this about the guy you drove home who's with the feds?
He came in for a drink, which turned into 10. He's hired muscle for some kind of safe house.
Where?
Oak Hill, corner of Pine. He gave me $10 to drive him back and keep my mouth shut. Let on that Councillor Gilotti's brokered some kind of deal between Morello and the FBI.
What?
We're all ready to sit tight on someone in there.
Why the hell didn't you tell us?
Tom, I did. I came in to see Frank straight away. He didn't tell the Don?
No. No, he didn't.
Tom.
Bugger.
What's going on?
I can't tell you. Terrails. Nice, thank you for that. Well, this is not looking good at all. There's definitely going to be some shooting involved here.
Looks like the place.
What the hell? Wow, properly parking this up. Like, properly parking up. Oh, Frank. I'll eat you, Frank. Oh no, I've actually got to do some driving now, guys. Okay, we do have a bar.
Take me to those account books, Frank.
Yeah, just take me to them.
And we return now to coverage what could be the final play of this game and the series between the Lost Heaven Lancers and the Empire Bay Cannons. A quick reminder that this final inning is being brought to you by Swift Cola. When you need a lift, reach for a Swift. It's not only a taste sensation, it's guaranteed to increase focus, drive, and mental clarity. Pick up a bottle of Swift Cola today. And as we are coming to a close, let me thank today's other sponsors.
I feel like cops are going to crash right into them there.
Lost Heaven Courier. Both of these teams could be said to be entering golden eras. Each team has a star player.
Oh, I didn't mean to peep my horn.
Promising youngsters set around them. I refer, of course, to Smith and Seidel. The Cannons have had several such golden periods. The Lancers, it's fair to say, have not. I can see Lancers manager Frankie Hodge prowling in front of the dugout, gesticulating. He seems animated, to say the least.
This will be baseball around about.
Officials in his place, or something or other. With the noise of the crowd, it is quite hard to say for sure. Whatever's going on down there, you can feel the sense of occasion. And
well, you've actually pulled right out in front of me. What do you think, hell do you think you're doing?
To tell you what has happened. The Lancers are now within minutes of snatching the Gold Series, which at one stage had appeared doomed, but they equally teeter on the edge of defeat. It all comes down to the final play. Nobody is warming up in the bullpen. Nobody down there is considering the possibility of extra innings.
Gotta be some kind of meat happening.
Bunny Smith then, standing on the mound, a look of steely determination on his face. He's betraying no emotion.
I take it if we're driven the whole journey, we'd be here in this baseball game the whole time.
Nor does he appear to be carrying the weight of expectation. He's having a word with the umpire about something or other. What a strapping fellow. 6'2", 195 pounds. If the Lancers are to win here today, he's going to write himself into the record books. And boy, oh boy, what that would mean to the people of Lost Heaven after such a long time without glory on the diamond. All right, they've sorted out whatever was going on. Here we go then. In for the Cannons, it's Paddy Dougherty. Smith is pitching the game of his life, but Dougherty's a big man. If he can catch one, it could run, and with bases loaded, the Cannons would have it. Here we go. Dougherty facing down Smith. Fastball and strike. The big man thought he had it. Some
Shit.
They're
digging you to the airport, Frank.
Dougherty looks a little spooked. He was convinced he had it.
Oh. That's really not good at all, is it?
Remains cool under pressure, not a flicker of emotion on his face. He winds up. And that's two. There was zip on that one. Good lord. Seidel is barking something at Dougherty, but we have no...
Track three.
...as the noise of the crowd reaches fever pitch. Dougherty's gesturing, and that's only making Seidel more irate. This is it, folks. Another strike, and the Lancers win. If Dougherty can get behind it, surely the Cannons will get all their men home and snatch victory. A swing and a miss, and that's the winners. Lancers win, Lancers win.
Yay.
Cracks an elated smile. He's thrown his cap in the air, as have his teammates. Lancers win the 1933 Gold Series.
And just straight to the music. We don't get any celebration or anything. Gosh, the airport seems like so. Oh, there it is. We're so out of the way.
Christ, they're flying him out of state or something.
Fucking flunk.
This ain't good.
Oh my days, the cops are all with us. They'll be going in the witness protection. And they are heavily armed. We don't exactly have a lot of, you know, a silent weapon or anything, do we? Good, he's going back in. That's how we'll get in as well. He's opened the door for us. Shut down airport. Informer and FBI escort leave safe house. Informer exchange and take it to Hangar 5. Accounts after important handover. Nice. Oh, the sword off the pistol. Good. Let's just move him out of sight.
Morello hasn't the honor to even show his face.
For a rat like you? Nah. Get in the car.
You're a rat. You're a rat, Frank.
Not once Morello gives us the books, our accounting guys go through them with a fine tooth comb.
That's why we'll round them up, pin charge them, and we know what stick keeps ourselves well enough for the scales to take. Ah, you sons of guns. Head around the side here. That building's open, so let's get in there. Oh my gosh, actual grenades.
The way they got Capone.
And now is how Ennio Salieri dies in jail.
It's a good day, my friend.
I didn't realize there was a second one. Nice. Nice indeed. Very nice. You only get 12 shots in the shotgun. There's a collectible in here. Let's go ahead and grab that.
It's gonna feel good handing over those account books to the Bureau. You think we can trust the feds?
I don't know how you get that collectible. I'm sure it's a collectible. Am I just blind? I'm gonna knock him out. It looks like it's out there. Loving this music though. It's very dramatic. Yep, here it is. This is what I was wanting. Oh, it's the Francoletti card. It's a great card. Night, bitch. Hi. I like how none of them are concerned at all for the blown up vehicles and dead bodies that are over here. Hello, Frank.
Tom.
Frank. The Don sent me.
I figured as much. I'm sorry it had to be you, Tommy.
Anything you want me to tell him?
I wish it could have shaken out better, but Morello finally came after me. It's okay. You can come out. Morello offered me a simple trade. The Don's account books for our lives and tickets out of this town.
You hand the books over yet?
I'm not so stupid, Don. They're safe. Morello was waiting for this.
It's a key to a box in the Grand Imperial Bank downtown.
I told Morello I'd hand it over after the plane was fueled and ready to go. His men were meant to fetch it before we left.
I took care of them. Told Henry to get on a plane.
Go on march, Alice. Get aboard.
Frank, you're coming with us.
Not right now, honey. Just get buckled in. Tommy and I, we have some serious business to discuss.
But Frank!
Get on the plane, March! For Alice. For me. Get on the goddamn plane, please.
Get out. Get on it.
You been paid yet?
Yeah.
Now you've been paid twice. You take the ladies wherever they want to go.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Tom.
Christ, Frank. Why didn't you ask us for help?
I guess I just wanted out. One way or the other. I'm tired, Tommy. Tired of lying to my wife. Tired of checking under my car every time I take a Sunday drive. And tired of waiting for the dawn to put two in my temple.
God damn you, Frank.
Oh. What if we're letting him go? Oh my god. What? Why are we letting him go? Tommy. What the hell are we gonna tell the Don? We let him get away. And again, he didn't handle the account books yet, so I guess we still got them they gotta pick up. But, interesting, Tommy. Interesting. Nice, this does the favor of skipping the journey. Ordin you! Get the account books from the bank. Yes, let's go.
Good afternoon, sir.
Aye.
Where's the safety deposit boxes?
With my colleague downstairs, sir.
Thanks.
Thank you. Hi, sir.
Beautiful day, huh?
It's absolutely fantastic.
Keeping out of trouble, I hope.
Why did you think I...
I need to access the deposit boxes for Frank Coletti.
Ah, yes. Mr. Angelo?
Yeah.
Mr. Coletti said it might be you who came, and to provide access. Please.
He knew. Frank bloody knew that it would be us. Gangsters Monthly. How? I'm gonna miss having Frank with us. Are we having a fake funeral now?
I got the books and covered my tracks. Salieri never asked any questions. In fact, apart from the funeral, I never heard him talk about Frank again.
You just setting the house on fire? Nice house to be burning, but oh well. Excuse me. Morello, seriously?
You're making my boys twitchy, Marco.
Sergio and I just came by to pay respects, that's all. Known Frank a long time. Almost as long as you. He's a good man. Smart. Loyal. Loyal to his wife. His kid above all else. There must be some kind of honor in that, in you.
Maybe. But I'm still looking at this headstone with his little girl's name on it.
It's a hell of a thing.
Okay. Not very often you get to see them both together in the same thing. Rat in the house. Omerta. Another chapter done, eh? Another one done. What's in store now? When are we going to deal with Morello? Are we going to have like another intermission, possibly? Has been a good few missions since we've checked in with Tommy and the detective. Visiting rich people. Still 1933. Very turbulent year for the boys. Very turbulent year.
Look at these houses. Big yards, white picket fences. It's the American dream,
eh? Oh, I'm back to not wearing my suit. What am I doing?
Not for you?
No, sir. I like being closer to the business.
Don't let the flower beds and front porches fool you. There's more criminals out here than in the rest of the city combined.
Are that why we're in the neighborhood?
In a way. Morell's got a dirty prosecutor on his payroll named Watkins. Turns out he's old friends with Galati.
The city councilor?
The same. Morell let drop that we might have had something to do with the Galati boy's death. Now Watkins is loaded for bear, trying to do right by his buddy. Word is, he's striking gold with a few witnesses.
You have names?
Yeah. But Paulie and Sam are taking care of them. I'm putting you on a different part of the job. We need whatever Watkins has got on us.
All right.
A safe in his villa.
I'm no safecracker.
Don't worry about that. We're taking you to meet Salvatore. He's fresh off the boat, but he knows how to pop open anything. Just get him into the villa, find the safe, and he'll do the rest.
What kind of rumpus should I expect?
Nothing you can't handle. Watkins is going to the theater, so the house should be empty except for a bit of muscle. The office is on the first floor, and our stoolie says the safe is in the wall. Once Salvatore has the safe open, grab all the evidence and get out.
Okay.
Yeah, that's our guy. Salvatore, tutto bene?
Sì, grazie. Don Salieri.
Good to see you. You know the job. Don't let me down.
Sì, ho capisco.
Tommy, if you bump into Watkins, don't kill him. It'll just bring down more heat.
You got it, bud.
Don't kill him.
Buona fortuna, ragazzi.
I don't know what that means, but it's Italian.
Tommy Angelo. Piacere di conoscerti.
Meraviglioso. Per favore.
Okay, it doesn't speak much English, hence why he's fresh off the boat. Expression there from Salieri to describe him. Skip drive. This will be an interesting mission. But is it going to go as easily as expected? Or is it going to end in fighting again? So in that last episode, not the last episode, the last mission there, we didn't exactly go too mental with the killing, really. We just knocked some guys out. Liking that car as well. Something about the old style cars, man. Love them.
Ecco. Entriamo da lì.
Gunfire will raise the alarm.
Wall. Labirinto. What? Vedrai.
Let's climb over here.
A maze.
Sì. Oh, labirinto.
Stay here while I take out the guards.
Per quanto pare, in America hanno il labirinto.
That's one. Good night. Okay, there is one over here. Can I climb over it? No, I've got the way around, but that's fine. As long as he doesn't turn around before I get done. He's having a good wee whistle to himself. And choke. I think I'm safe to put a wee bit of a sprint on. Okay, got another guard over there to the right. I'll just take that just in case it goes sideways. You know, just precautionary. Super science.
Oh,
Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. Position here. Really not in a good position, actually. When's he gonna turn around? Uh oh. Convenient. Deal with him. Choke him, man, boy.
I think that's all of them.
And a Tommy gun, thank you.
Where are you? We're clear.
Tommy! I hear!
Where the hell did he go?
Sono qui, Tommy!
Guy's a pain in the ass.
Forza! Vieni con me! Tommy! I hear!
Uff! Sei un tipo tosto, eh?
What?
This is a bit awkward, you know. The language barrier.
C'è un'entrata. Open. Kick.
What kind of lock picker are you?
Look for a dipinto.
What?
Da Vinci, Caravaggio. Hai capito?
Painting? You're saying it's behind a painting?
Sì, sì.
Okay, I understand.
Non quello.
Guess we got another room to check.
Okay.
Another here. Salvatore.
There's something there. I take it that's not usable.
All behind here.
It's on the first floor, so.
There's one.
Delightful.
Fuck, there's someone here.
Sure, it's behind one of these, Salvatore.
What the hell are you doing here? Oh, burglars! Help! We need help in here!
I do not condone violence. That was... I thought the painting maybe would have been in here. Yeah, okay, that's not exactly what I wanted to do, but it was necessary. The hell?
Qui c'è un altro dipinto.
It's gonna be behind this.
Nothing again.
Or not. Where the hell would I need help by now? It's getting redone. Oh, it's in here. 100% behind this as well. Yep.
Scusa.
Sure. Show me what you can do. Shit. Be quick, Salvatore.
Pacienza, pacienza.
Let him do his thing.
Spider-Man.
What?
Intrappolato.
Doesn't matter. Come on, we need to get out of here.
Vai dietro, dietro.
They gotta be upstairs. The safe's in his study.
I can't even get a line of sight on you.
Stay back! I'll deal with him.
There!
Run at the fire!
They're on to me! Gonna reload!
Blow it, Bob!
Here!
Get a better shot! Go!
Get your first time.
Ah, no, this language barrier has really not helped us. Oh, I've left something behind in there. I can't even bother going for it. I'll get it my own time.
Presto! Semina gli spiriti!
I know! Whatever you're saying, I know!
Police?
Yep. Yeehaw.
Ah, lavorare con te è sempre così?
What? Oh my god.
Grazie a Dio.
Salvatore.
Holy shit.
Do I take you now?
Home.
Yeah. We're home.
Yeah.
Six, and,
what the f-
Okay, let's go.
What the actual fuck, like? Oh, please let me land. We're coming in hot. Oh shit, there's a fence! Oh, there we go. I fixed it. Oh my days. I love it when I break games.
Cristo Santissimo!
Yeah, skip drive, please. Oh, no way. No way. What a break. What a break in the game there. Oh, fantastic.
Good night.
Night.
Yeah, goodbye. Our mission done. Oh. Oh, jeez. I don't know what I would have done if I'd had to jump at the car there and fall to my death. But there's another mission done, so we managed to get two done this episode, which is quite nice. We'll see what's going to be happening now. Great deal. Still 1933. Okay, we're back at the warehouse.
This is the last of the good stuff, boss.
I know. Some of those bottles I've had for 10 years. But we gotta make payroll.
Oh, times are tough.
You've heard them. Load it up.
Good to see you, boys.
Boss, Any word on a job I pulled with Salvatore?
You did fine, Tom. Galati's got nothing on us now. We bought some time. At least until the money runs out.
Don't go selling off the farm yet, boss.
Sam says you worked out an angle.
Yeah, and you're gonna love it. We make a few bucks and knock out a couple of Morello's teeth, too.
Okay, what's the rumpus?
A couple of weeks ago, I'm relaxing in the cigar lounge at the Blue Tropics.
Where?
Some small-time whorehouse. It's just a couple of closets with some mattresses on the floor.
It's a gentleman's club. They got a bar and everything. Anyways, one of the Johns is soused, and he's crying to the madam about all his troubles. He catches my ear on account of his goofy accent. He's going on and on about how he just landed this huge payday. But the goons he's working for are already twisting his arm, and he's got the busted nose to show for it.
You pick up his tab?
Hell no. But I walked him out of the place, took him to the diner around the corner to sober up. We get to talking. Turns out his name is Gates. He's this hick up from Kentucky.
Moonshiner?
Better. His pop's got a couple of real distilleries, and I'll give you one guess as to their exclusive buyer around these parts.
Morello.
And you think he wants to burn bridges?
Oh, yeah. I've been working him steady, boss. He's bringing up another shipment tonight, but he's got his entire crew ready to roll over. Mm. All we gotta do is make it look like a proper heist.
I don't know, Polly. You really trust this guy?
Yeah, this could be disastrous. Well,
I'll tell you that. Not like we got a lot of options here.
We'll be coming. Yeah, this is not good at all, is it?
Soon, boss.
What do you think, Tom?
We need to replace the Canadian. If Polly says this Gates can do that, I'm in.
Where's the meat?
The big parking garage downtown.
Okay, do it. But you better not be playing grab ass this time. You take Carlo and little Bill with you.
Sure thing, boss.
Once you have the truck, drive it back here.
Okay.
Walk down, boss.
Don't make me regret giving you some time out there in the streets with the guys, Carlo.
You don't have to worry about it.
I know I don't. Tommy does that for me.
I'll keep your driver safe, boss.
Buona fortuna, boys.
Sam and little Bill said to meet him downtown.
Okay, anyways, guys, I'm going to leave that episode there, so thank you very much for watching. We'll get into this mission next episode, so until then, take care, cheer bye, then now.